This is Galaxy Tab S7 FE, a large 12.4-inch Android tablet from Samsung. So before I review this tablet, the obvious question to ask is, why would anyone spend money on this device when you can buy an iPad? After all, iPads have been dominating the tablet landscape for over a decade now, while most Android tablets have languished behind. So in this video, I will dissect Samsung's Galaxy Tab S7 FE and help you decide whether it's worth your money or not. So let's start with the included S Pen. Samsung does what Apple refuses to do, which is to include an active stylus pen with your tablet. Don't expect your customers to shell out another $130 after they have already spent a grand buying a tablet. That's just stupid. In my opinion, this is actually a highway robbery. I think the included S Pen is a fantastic accessory because it makes Galaxy Tab S7 FE a very useful and a very versatile tablet. Samsung has been perfecting the S Pen for years, and it shows. So this pen offers 4000 levels of pressure sensitivity, making it not just good for sketching, but also great for creating digital art and taking notes. Its pressure sensitivity works smoothly across a wide range of apps, including third-party apps. So I never felt any lagginess while using Adobe Sketch, Photoshop Express, Autodesk Sketchbook, Bamboo Paper, and even Microsoft's OneNote, which is notorious for being slow and laggy when used with an active pen. Added bonus is that Samsung's built-in Notes app offers surprisingly good handwriting recognition. There is a single button on the side of S Pen and it acts as an eraser. When you bring the S Pen close to the screen, a list of useful S Pen apps pop up. My favorite is the Screen Write app, which I use to annotate screenshots. In my opinion, Samsung's S Pen is right up there with Apple Pencil when it comes to latency and usability. Next, let's talk about the screen on Galaxy Tab S7 FE. So you are getting a large 12.4-inch 16:10 aspect ratio screen with a resolution of 1600x2560. This roughly translates to 243 pixels per square inch, which is comparable to 264 ppi offered by the far more expensive iPad Pro. Its screen supports HDR10+, which means you can enjoy your favorite shows from Netflix, Disney Plus, and Amazon Prime in their full white color gamut. Galaxy Tab S7 FE is using a TFT LCD panel instead of AMOLED panel used by the more expensive Galaxy Tab S7, but it is still a very good screen, delivering over 430 nits of brightness that can shoot up to 520 nits in bright daylight. Texts look sharp, colors look vibrant, and the contrast ratio is about 1900:1, which is very impressive for an LCD screen. I especially like the 16:10 aspect ratio, which is great for multimedia consumption. Complementing this large 12.4-inch screen is a pair of AKG-tuned Dolby Atmos speakers. The two speakers are placed symmetrically on the shorter side, creating a perfect stereo separation when holding this tablet in landscape mode. They are fairly loud and deliver decent bass. Since Samsung has equipped this tablet with a massive 10,090 mAh battery, you will be able to enjoy multimedia content on this tablet for many hours. In fact, during my testing, I started with 100% battery, and after watching a full movie, followed by web browsing and some social media scrolling, the battery was still sitting at 60%. So Samsung claims around 12 hours of battery life, and honestly, I think they are not exaggerating. That is the battery life that you are going to get on this tablet. Added bonus is support for 45-watt fast charging, which is really awesome. Since this is the Galaxy Tab S7 Fan Edition, Samsung has cut some corners with the specs. So instead of using a flagship chip like the Snapdragon 865, this tablet is powered by Qualcomm S7-7325 SoC. In Geekbench 5, this SoC scored 781 points in single core and 2843 points in the multi-core test. Now, these numbers are not going to break any benchmark record, but for day-to-day tasks, I find Galaxy Tab S7 FE very snappy. You get a choice of 4, 6 or 8GB RAM configuration, but I would recommend picking either the 6 or the 8GB RAM configuration for best performance. More RAM will also be very helpful with the DeX mode, which is the single best feature on this tablet. When connected to an external monitor, keyboard and mouse, this tablet transforms into a full-fledged computer. So the operating system switches from tablet to a PC mode, giving you a Windows 10-like desktop environment. In this mode, you can move the cursor with your mouse You can type with the keyboard and you can resize each app window and switch between apps because you have got a full-fledged task manager. Added bonus is that the tablet screen is also functional, which means you enjoy a kick-ass dual screen setup for maximum productivity. So when it comes to using your tablet as a computer, iPad Pro cannot hold a candle to Galaxy Tab S7 FE. Now, I have been using this tablet in DeX mode for a while now, and I have not faced any performance issues while surfing websites, watching streaming videos, running productivity apps, including emailing and word processing. But unfortunately, if you are a hardcore gamer, you will be disappointed. So I tried Fortnite and I got around 30 FPS in HD resolution. So that's fine for casual gaming, but if you want to play with your friends and if you want to do a competitive gameplay, you know, this tablet isn't really the device that you would like to use. Since we are in a perpetual world of quarantining and social distancing, let's talk about the cameras on this tablet. So the two cameras on the Galaxy Tab S7 FE, they capture up to 1080p resolution videos at 30 frames per second. The video quality from the front camera is pretty good for Zoom video conference calls, and the 12-hour battery life means you can zoom all day without needing to recharge your tablet. The 1080p video recording from the rear camera, I think it's outstanding. You get a sharp, detailed video with excellent contrast, very good dynamic range, and color reproduction. Added bonus is that this tablet supports expandable storage, so you can put an SD card and you can record to your heart's content. You will never run out of space. Okay guys, so here is the $1 million question. Why not buy an iPad instead of Galaxy Tab S7 FE? Obviously, the first consideration is the price. To get an equivalent 12.4 inch tablet from Apple, you will have to go with the 12.9 inch iPad Pro, which costs $1,100, and it still does not include an Apple Pencil. So you will have to shell out another $130 for the Pencil. Galaxy Tab S7 FE, on the other hand, starts at little over $500, and it includes the S Pen with that price. But of course, iPad Pro will kick this tablet's ass when it comes to performance and also the quality of the screen. So if you plan to edit 4K videos and if you plan to run a lot of graphics intensive apps, the iPad Pro is obviously going to be a better choice. But for most folks who just want to watch videos, make some sketches and jot down some notes, I think Galaxy Tab S7 FE is a far more prudent choice. Now, if you are a power user who wants dual screen desktop mode with keyboard and mouse support for peak multitasking, I think Samsung's DeX mode is the only game in town. Apple has really no answer for that. So that's it for today, guys. Let me know, what do you think of Galaxy Tab S7 FE? I hope you guys found this video useful. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out technopandareviews.com, where I have consolidated all the reviews that I have done here on this channel. So again, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.